She's just bursting out into tears.
Just tuning into Boris's update.
We got locked in by the time. How I felt about A-level being cancelled. It will get you and you'll be like, oh, and you get a bit down. Hey guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. So, long time no see. I've been really inactive on my YouTube channel, and basically it's because I've just been revising non-stop for my A-levels, which are now cancelled. So anyway, I'm gonna try and get back onto YouTube, and I've decided to start off with a little vlog, kind of showing you what I'm getting up to during quarantine. It's not necessarily lockdown. It's currently Wednesday, so Boris Johnson did announce his kind of update. I think it was Monday. I mean, in my opinion, he didn't actually say the words lockdown, so we're still allowed out for exercise and only essential shopping and stuff, so I think it's getting towards that way, but we're still allowed a little bit of freedom on a walk, so that's what I'm doing currently. I'm just on the beach, very lovely views and lovely weather. So yeah, I'm just gonna kind of keep you updated on what I get up to. I'm gonna try and do dance classes at home, stretching, conditioning, workouts, artsy things. I'm learning how to play the piano. Just kind of talk to you about how I feel about A-levels being cancelled and just kind of touch base with how my life's going during these days. So yeah, keep watching if you want to see what I get up to in the next few days during quarantine. So we actually just had to change our route because we got locked in by the tide, which is pretty scary. It's so sunny and I think it's times like these that you've got to like embrace and be grateful for all the things that we do have, because there's a lot of misery right now. But like just going out on a walk, my family having the time to do that, the lovely sun, and yeah, something to be grateful for, isn't it? And I think there's a lot of things that we can be grateful for, and it just makes the hard times a little bit easier. So yeah, that's my top tip of the day. I haven't actually ate today, so I've just sat down outside in the lovely sun to have poached egg on toast. My dog's a little shadow because he loves food, so he's also hanging out with me. But this is the type of stuff that I never get to do, just sit down outside and enjoy something to eat. I'm always rushing from place to place, eating in the car, madness. So it is quite nice just to have some time, a lot of time on my hands. So I've just been sunbathing outside. The weather is so, so nice. And on my Instagram, the Jazz Associates page popped up saying that they're going to do a live jazz technique class right now at 2. So I'm quickly going to get changed and hopefully join into that and do some fun jazz technique dancing. So yes, that's my plans for the next hour. So I just did 2 classes. The first was jazz technique. I'll put some clips of me doing some like cardio and leg kicks and the type of technique we did in that class in. And I also then did a contemporary class with Adam Scott, which was so, so good. And it's just, I love dancing. It's my favorite thing to do, so it's great that I can still do it. And I'm so grateful to the teachers who are still putting classes up there on Instagram. I would definitely recommend, even if you're not a dancer, in the dancers, they're not putting massive like legs and leaps and turns. Like, it was all about movement and fluidity, so it was such a great class and it's really got my spirits up. So I'm probably gonna chill now, to be honest, and watch a bit of TV. I also want to get around to talking about how like I feel about A-levels being cancelled, but I'm very aware that I don't want it to be like, oh, I'm really upset about A-levels, when there's bigger kind of fish to fry, when there's like health problems and etc. with the coronavirus. But obviously in my life, A-levels being cancelled was pretty drastic, so I probably will get around to talking about that also. But yes, I feel like I'm rambling a lot in this video, so apologies if so. I don't know about you all, but I'm certainly snacking a lot. Coffees and biscuits and chocolate. All this time just isn't good for the diet.
Obviously, a key part of the day, and has been for the last few weeks, is tuning into Boris's updates at Downing Street every night, waiting for the big announcement, which is pretty scary. It's almost like wartime, the way he announces things, but yes, that's part of the daily routine. So for the rest of the night, I've just been on FaceTime to my three school friends. We were on FaceTime for like an hour and a half, and it did brighten my spirits, to be honest, because we have a good laugh. But we played Psych, which I would definitely recommend, and we just had a good chat. And then I also had tea, and I've kind of been on my phone for quite a lot of the night, so I'm gonna go to sleep now. But I'll be back tomorrow with some fun things. See you tomorrow night. Morning. So I've just woke up and got changed. I'm gonna go do my skincare routine, and then I'm gonna go join into a body conditioning Instagram class. I'm going to start the body conditioning workout now, but another part of my daily routine in the morning is always filling up this bottle of water, which I usually have a lemon in because I just think it tastes nicer. So I'm set for the day with some water. Also take vitamin C, vitamin D. Gotta extend those vitamins. Apparently they've been proved to really help what's going on with coronavirus, so trying to stick to that. See you in a bit. Workout complete, so I'm gonna eat, shower, and get ready for the day. So I'm just on a dog walk with my mum at the beachfront. It's really lovely weather, and it's just been nice to get some fresh air and a bit of exercise for the day. Hey, so I thought I'd take a small part of this video just to kind of talk about how I felt about A-levels being cancelled, because I know sometimes my channel has been quite school-based with revision videos and school results videos, etc. And obviously A-levels were a huge part of my life. I put blood, sweat and tears into my three subjects, which was chemistry, biology and maths. And I literally would revise for nights on end, hours and hours, true hard work. And I'm not gonna lie, it come as a bit of a shock when they were cancelled. And I can picture myself about this time last week when Boris Johnson announced it, literally just bursting out into tears. I know for a lot of people it was quite a, yes, do I have to do exams, like, you know, pressure. And I know some people kind of saw it as a good thing that they wouldn't have to go through the ordeal of exams, which I totally understand. I hate exams. I was going to have a few months of absolute hell. And in that way, I am a little bit relieved. But at the same time, I am a bit disappointed because I got this far. Seems a bit of an anti-climax to not have the final exam and not kind of finish with a big tick in the box and be like, I'm done. So at first I was a bit like, I'm just going to be handed grades that aren't truly mine. But having thought about it a bit more, it actually seems a little bit more representative because it's not going to be on a 2-hour exam. It's instead going to be on a full 2-year course that I'm going to be assessed on, in how I was in class, in coursework, in little tests, in mock tests. So it's a little bit more fair in some aspects. It's not on just one exam. And I'm just trying to get my head around it. If I'm being honest, it's still not quite sunk in. I love to like work hard and achieve something, and it feels great. Like the proudest day of my life, I'd probably have to say, was getting my GCSE results, because I literally put so much work in and it really paid off. And that's not just because I got like 9.9s, it's because whatever my best was, I achieved it because of the hard work I put in, and I just wanted to feel that again on results day. And I know loads of students out there felt that they didn't get to kind of show their true potential, and I'm so sorry to everyone, because I know
My brother's in the same position with GCSEs, and uni students are even worse off. So I don't want to be like, woe is me. I know there's so many worse situations to be in. But I was upset, and I just thought I'd share that. If you are going through a similar thing where your kind of world has been turned upside down with school, then I hope you're okay. And like, we'll all get through it, obviously. The main thing to think about is, if you're a perfectionist like me and you thought that now you're just going to get handed grades, you're not, because you worked for those predicted grades or those mock results, even though it wasn't the same format of an exam that you thought it was going to be. You still worked throughout the year. You should still be proud of yourself. Obviously, we've got to stay positive in these circumstances, and we're all going to get results, and hopefully they'll be representative of what you are like as a student. I'm sure there'll be other options to appeal and resit. So fingers crossed everyone gets the results that they deserve. Keep working hard if you're in like year 10 or year 12 or the younger down years. You still obviously need to be doing work at home with school online. That's really, really important, because you will have exams. And yeah, that's kind of my update in relation to school. I'm done, which is crazy. I didn't really get a proper countdown. It just kind of all came, sprang on me. I'm done with school, which is a bit sad. But I had a nice last day, and I got to say bye to all my friends and teachers, who I'm so grateful for. And yeah. So as sad as this may sound, my plans for the evening, Harry Potter number one. I loved the films, but I've never actually sat down to read the books because I've just never had the time, which I know is an absolute outrage. You should always read a book before you watch the film. But I'm finally going to get around to doing that. So I'm going to start and going to try and get through the book series. So I've just been reading for quite a bit, and now at 8, the whole nation, I think, is going to get on their doorstep and start clapping for the NHS, which is so nice because we all want to show how grateful we are, because they've literally been our heroes throughout all of this. So I'm going to go do that now. That was actually so emotional. Like, we all nearly started crying. I don't think you could really tell on the video because I videoed it right at the start. But by the end of like the minute, the whole road was actually cheering and clapping. And it was just so nice to see that we're all pulling together. And it's really brightened my spirits up, because you go through phases of being quite like okay with it, and then it all gets you and you're a bit like, oh, and you get a bit down. And that was just so lovely to see that we're all pulling together, doing something nice. I think for the rest of the night, I'm just going to FaceTime friends. I've been playing Words with the Friends, which is like a Scrabble game you can play. And also Psych with my friends, which has been quite good fun throughout the day. I think we're going to do that a bit more tonight. Peak sadness, but you know, it's good in these desperate, boring times. So yeah, and then I'll probably see you tomorrow. Morning. So this morning I've already done a workout with Jennifer Elson, who's my dance teacher. It was a body conditioning class, and I did it with my dad, and it was so hard. It literally destroyed me, but it feels so good to have got through it. And now I'm just on a walk on the beach. Since I've got back from the walk, I've ate, I've FaceTimed Annie, and I've also applied for a few online work experience placements, because even though I want to go into dancing and acting and modeling, I also want to keep my options open. And keeping up with like work experience for like financial companies is really important. And I'm on a website called Uptree, which provides opportunities in that kind of sector of business. But because of what's happening with the coronavirus, they're doing online activities and workshops, which you can like watch live. So I've just applied for a few of them. I'm gonna eat my tea now, and then I'm gonna maybe tidy my room. I've been putting that off all day, but might get around to it. So the state of my room is actually horrendous. I'm embarrassed to even show you guys, but I think it's gonna be really satisfying when it's neat and tidy. So I am gonna show you the before, because then you can see the after, but don't judge, because I've let it build, because I knew I was gonna do it properly. So I tidied my room, and you can watch the TikTok that I made to see the final result.
When I popped off, then your girl gave me just a little bit of lunch.
So that's the end of my YouTube video. Thank you so much for watching. I really hope that everyone's staying safe and staying at home. Send love to you all at this hard time. I really hope everyone's okay. And yeah, please make sure to subscribe to my channel. Give this video a thumbs up. Follow my Instagram account, which is @poppygerard_x. Bye guys. Love you all. See you next time.